it. I'm going to do the final fitting on myself. And show you just the measurements that I'm going to use to transfer them onto the gamiz. So at the bust point, just the frontal view, is a 22-inch marking. Waist at the front, it's 19 inches, and on the hip point is 21 inches. So these markings I need to transfer onto the gamiz. The hip was 21, so I need to finish this off, leaving exactly same allowance on both the sides. I'm going to mark this off 21. The waist, I want 19 inches. This was the point of the waist, so 19 inches comes about here. So leaving equal distance on both sides, I've just marked that off. On the bust point, again, this is 22 inches, so leaving just marginal. Now what we can do is use our curved ruler to actually mark this off. That is the seam line that we're going to use to actually fit this gamiz out on. You don't really need, this was just one of the gadgets that we actually acquired recently, but let me assure you, there's really, you can do it just manually. You don't really need gadgets like these to actually do the initial stitching. Sleeve, it's a little bit wide, so what I'm going to do is from the point of the armhole, I'm going to take it in quite a bit, and then I'm going to slightly curve it out. I don't want to I want it overly fitted at the front because I want it easily going up for doing wudu. So slightly fitted around this area, so I'm going to take it in quite a bit. It's as I said earlier, it's a little bit of flimsy fabric, so I don't want it overly tight because obviously it's going to give in on the seams if I'm overly if I overly tighten it on the seams. And basically that's about it. Now having looking at the back, what will happen is when I took those measurements, obviously the back is going to be narrower due to the fact that we've already placed darts in this. But I'm going to leave exact seam fabric on both the sides. I want the back to be slightly more in to give the gamiz a fitted look.